In this lesson, I will show you how to start a project, customize your design, and add content inside your app. I'm in the back end of a new project. Let's begin the customization following the wizard. So this project has been assigned a random theme. You can change the theme anytime. Consider the theme as an inspiration and a starting point. You can customize everything that has been set up with a theme. And now, let the customization begin. Let's start to set up the menu. 9 navigation modes are available. Grid, swipe, tab bar, typo, little swipe, slate, large typo, classic tab bar. The last mode is called From Scratch and is for CV developers. You can create your own navigation with this mode. You can modify different options depending on the navigation mode. Logo of the icons. Header of the menu. Background image of the menu. And much more other options you can discover for each navigation mode. Let's have a look now at the header and the body. The header is the information displayed at the top of your app. You can choose to insert a text, choose its font, modify the background image of this area, or if you want, you can put logo instead of a text. When you upload your logo, pay attention to the dimensions. Let's customize now the body of the app and start with the background. So the background is what appears below the content of your app. You can select the color, or if you prefer, you can upload an image. So here I'm going to upload an image for the portrait version of my iPad app. But if I want, I can also upload a different image for the landscape mode in my iPad app. Let's now add some content. Content is organized by sections. Each section is designed for a type of content. Let's start to play with articles. When you add a new section, you need to choose between two content sources. It can be an internal source, and in that case, you're going to use the CMS included in your backend. Or it can be an external source, and in that case, you're going to connect a third-party platform to your app. If you don't see a ready-made connector for the platform you're hosted your content on, you can always build your own connector. Let's use the CMS and create a new article. An article is made with a title, one or several paragraphs, and some meta information. Paragraphs can contain text, images, videos, and more, depending on what you want to put inside. Use the panel to organize your content inside your app, and also to set up some information that will be needed in some views of your app. Let's have a look now on how to design your sections. Sections are made of two types of views, and each view is customizable. A list of items, and the item itself. Depending on the section you're working on and the type of content is connected to, you'll be able to choose among several templates to display the list of items. The ID is the same for items. Several templates are available. As usual, you can edit your template to customize it. You can customize the display of the content, the toolbar, and also the navigation options. Keep in mind that depending on your template, some customization options can be available or not. We are almost done setting up our project. Let's choose now the launching screen. The launching screen is the first image people see when they open your app. You need to make it pixel perfect. So two sizes for the iPhone, one size for Android, and two sizes for the iPad. If you don't have this pixel perfect image, you can still use our wizard to create one. The final element needed to complete your project is the icon. The icon is the image used to display your app on the springboard of the phone, and also it's the image used to display your app in the stores. Don't forget to put a name under your icon, because this is what people will see on their springboard so that they can start to enjoy your great app. I hope you enjoyed this video. I see you next time, and meanwhile, happy app building!